Right now, we will pause for a moment of silence in honor of Selena's death.
The mood at Bryan's KBMA says it all. This morning, the station and its listeners honored Selena with a moment of silence at the same time as her body was laid to rest in Corpus Christi.
Dice el poema. Y comienza así.
Some even expressed their feelings in a poem.
Lágrimas de hielo se esparcieron.
But Selena meant a lot to the younger generation as well. Lewis Zeters is a junior at Bryan High School and has been listening to Selena's music for a couple of years now. He says she is one of his favorites.
Blew me away. It's one of those things that 30, 40 years from now, I'll remember it, you know, I'll remember it just like with Kennedy and Elvis and all that.
Janie Hall's Spanish class at Bryan High School paid tribute to Selena all day today. The students were able to watch the funeral, read the latest, and listen to her last recorded album. Ironically enough, Hall is from Selena's neighborhood in Corpus Christi and knew her family.
You know, when she was off tour, she always went to the schools. She had a real rapport with children. She did the DARE program in Corpus Christi, so she stood for high moral values.
She was a model for all teenagers, especially for Hispanics, and she was just...
We'll miss her. She's definitely one to be missed.
Our hearts are heavy in the midst of sadness and sorrow that seems to have no rhyme or reason.
Hundreds of people gathered outside the La Fabulosa radio station this evening. They held their candles and remembered the singer who took Tejano to a new level. But it wasn't just Selena's music that attracted both the young and old to her.
She was unlike other artists in that she was very personal with her fans. No matter how big she was, she always winked at you, she always waved at you, she always smiled at you.
She was like family, even though we didn't know her, you know, like personal, but you know, she was like family to us.
She will always be in our hearts, and her memories will always be here.
Roy Lopez remembers Selena in her early teens singing in his family's nightclub in Bryan.
She just didn't support the Hispanic community. She gave what the Hispanic community was all about. If you notice, all these people are together. She was loved. She was very, very important to us.
I don't think it was fair. She wasn't only an artist, you know, she was a friend.
She's always going to be in my heart.
Her songs and her spirit. So it's going to live on.
I think there's no one else that's going to replace Selena. It's just indescribable, really.
Though Selena Quintanilla may be gone, she won't ever be forgotten. Governor George W. Bush has proclaimed today as Selena Day here in the state of Texas. Hundreds of folks here in the Brazos Valley gathered at KBMA Radio in Bryan to remember the slain star.
She emphasized a lot on these kids. She inspired these, you know, younger generation. She was there for them. And to me, that's why today it means a lot to me, and as well as to these other people here.
Everybody trying to celebrate her birthday, not because she's gone or what happened, but what she meant to the Mexican-American people.
Folks of all ages wore shirts bearing Selena's pictures and listening to her music. The Grammy Award-winning star was fatally shot March 31st by a former assistant. Yolanda Saldivar is currently jailed, awaiting her day in court.